Hi, how are you?
You've been here all day.
1FM is a peculiar name.
It's our new name. We're no longer just plain old Radio 1, because we're all FM'd up now.
Okay, 1FM.
No longer medium wave. Now, you've been here all day.
Yeah.
And, in fact, David, I should really come to you first, because you've been to Maida Vale before. I mean, do you remember it?
Oh, do I remember Maida Vale? No, I just remember the money, Mark.
Yeah, 15 quid, I think it was, in 1972.
Was it that much? Yes, it was something like that.
Yeah. It's a very long time. And Hunt, this is your first visit.
Yes.
What's it?
No, he's just been told how much he's getting paid as well. So I wouldn't expect too much out of it.
That's why I was a little bit quiet about it.
From Cleveland to here, I'm pretty excited that we're here today. Hold on, I'm falling asleep. Let me wake myself up.
I can tell.
It's Hunt's enthusiasm that keeps this band together.
I can understand that.
Ask me the secret of my success.
What is the secret?
Timing.
Exactly. That's the secret of good comedy. Timing. I know the gag. This is rather different from the way we normally record sessions. All the bands that do our show sessions come here for a day and they record four tracks and they mix them. Doing the thing completely live, Hunt, is rather different.
Yes, it is. I think it's the way to do it. If there's any mistakes, then we can kick ourselves later, but the audience, I guess, can feel part of it, you know, like a live show or something. That's what radio started out like.
I'm absolutely right, yeah. I mean,
the only thing we're sorry about is that we didn't wear full evening dress.
Like BBC used to.
Yes, I was going to feel bad about that.
I was going to say that you have a good face for radio.
That's about it, I think. That really is about it. I mean, for example, nowadays in the UK, when you do TV shows, you do get asked to mime. I know that on Paramount City, you did
sung live. Yeah. Well, we're miming on the next two things that we're doing, but we kind of don't really care because we're only there to do the single, to sell it. So, you know.
But this
is great to be able to do something like this. We are, in fact, miming today.
I thought you were going to say that. I was waiting for that. I really was.
I'm sorry.
One question for you, David, because this is a crucial question, and this would seem to be a very good way of you doing what you're famous for doing, which is reinventing yourself and giving yourself another way to make music, and by getting these guys to make you not do what you used to do.
I'm going to reinvent myself as a crossbow. That's been my big ambition this year.
But does it work
like
that?
I want to reinvent myself as an inanimate object.
Are they very good at saying, no, we're not going to do that, we're going to do what we want to do?
No.
You still boss them around then?
Oh, of course, don't I, Hunt?
What?
I would never even dream of trying to boss any of these guys around.
David's an old friend.
It wouldn't even occur to me to try.
You know. So it's like...
I mean, we actually, Tony, Hunt and myself met about 17 years ago. We were working with
Iggy Pop right?
Yeah, but the more important thing is that when we went out on tour with them, I was playing keyboards for him in that period. And during the sound checks, we used to do a lot of jamming together, just the three of us, waiting for Jim to come to the sound check. And during the course of doing those things, we really got some good stuff together, and we always said, oh, we're going to get this together one day. And one day was like, you know, 17 years later. What with the advent of meeting Reeves about 4 years ago.
You know that old saying, how time flies when your teeth are clean.
Yes, I know that old saying.
We're going to talk with Reeves and Tony later on, because it will be interesting, because Reeves obviously seems to be the sort of focal point of how this eventually all did come together, and it all became tied up at the end.
A focal point? I don't know about that. No. Yes, apparently.
Allow him that.
I think actually I'm the focal point of this thing. But
I thought I was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we three really, and Tony kind of backs us.
Just occasionally plays bass, and that's
That's
cool.
David and me.
Tony's our backing band.
David and me are actually really here to make Reeves and Tony look good.
What are you going to do tonight?
We're doing four songs for the new album and one song from the old album.
Right.
Do you want to know what they are?
No, you can surprise us later on.
We'll surprise you.
Well, tonight the show is live from the Maida Vale studios. Hunt Sales, Tony Hales, Reeve Gabriels and David Bowie are Tim Machine. David, welcome to Radio 1.
Hi. A big hi on behalf of Tony Hales.
Tony Hales?
Sales, I said. What's your first song?
Oh, no, you didn't. It's called A Big Hurt.
I'm
Exclusively live on 1FM, Tin Machine. More later. Judging by our previous talk with the other two members of Tin Machine, I'm ready for this next interview. I'm prepared now. I wasn't quite ready last time. We got Rhys Gabrils and Tony Sales, who's practicing his London. What part of London specifically?
I'm from Los Angeles, London. Right, isn't it? Okay.
Let's talk about the new album, because it's a step forward, Rhys, from the last album. What I mean by that is it's a step into more melody than the last album.
Yeah, well, the first record we'd all just met. I mean, we all just collected and went in the studio. I mean, we did Heavens and Here, the first track on that record, which we'll be playing later tonight. Mm. The day before we met, we went in the studio. Next day, we did it, and that whole album was done in that.
And then we recorded Heavens and Here.
Right, and that whole album was done in that that way, just immediate. Mm. In the interim, we toured. You know, we rode around on the bus together. We finished the record.
Tell it like it is, brother.
And so the new record, I think you're seeing the fact that the band has learned to play together better and doesn't have to. We're not throwing as much information back and forth at each other. I told you this was the serious.
Yeah, you're the articulate one so far.
You know, I've actually been working on something, and I've been saving it for night, and I'd like to juggle for the folks at home.
Can you do that for later?
Can I do it now?
Do you really want to
do it now?
Go on. It's good on the radio.
All right, here we go.
That's amazing.
Round of applause for the rest of the band, please.
Sorry.
You all live in different parts of the world, though. I mean, in terms of being a cohesive band, that must make things rather more difficult, Tony.
Yes, actually it does. I live in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And Reeves lives, where do you live?
In Boston.
In Boston.
Yeah.
And David has houses and homes
all
everywhere.
Over the place. Yeah.
Yes. Everywhere. You have that.
Do you have anywhere you call home?
You have that apartment complex in Compton, don't you?
Yes, I do. Several, in fact.
Why record the album in Australia, Reeves?
So that people would not bother us, right. And we'd be able to just get about the business of making the music.
Mm.
Pretty much. Plus, the fact that we found over the course of recording together that we went to new places where we didn't know people and a new environment, it affected us in that we'd kind of collect together a little more and
wait till it started to bother us.
Yeah,
then we'd go on someplace.
And you also have collective experiences then that you can write about.
Yeah. I mean, I suppose, you spend time together and you force yourselves to be together, it's more likely that you're going to have something.
Now, we didn't force ourselves to be. Yeah, I guess we did, actually, didn't we?
That's cool.
No, we didn't force ourselves to be together.
Sort of like a class trip.
And on that note, go back to your guitars.
They had
Thank
some
you.
Bass and lead. Exclusively live, a second song from Tin Machine.
One, two, three, four.
Baby, 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 baby.
Ready, steady, lost, found, stop, go, up, down. Ready, steady, lost, found, stop, go, up, down. Ready, steady, lost, found, stop, go. Somebody has no sense of destination.
Universal from the forthcoming Tin Machine album, Tin Machine 2. And totally live, and of course previewing songs on the new album, which is out September 2nd, and also songs that you'll be able to see on the tour, which starts in October. Hunt Sales on drums, and also, I believe, Hunt on vocals on this next song.
Yeah, we have a little thing here we want to do for you, a little blues thing.
Go for it, man.
We'll dedicate this to Little Itch back in Compton.
Hold on, let me get my stick. Yeah. I think I hurt myself.
If there was something I could do.
Exclusively live on 1FM, Tim Machine. And if that doesn't want to make you go and see them in concert in October, nothing would. Thank you, David. Thank you, Reeves. Thank you, Hunt. Thank you, Tony. And my thanks. And my thanks to Jeff Smith and to Mike Robinson. And I'll see you tomorrow night for the evening session back at base.